Hi, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. My name is Joe Castellanos, and I'm a program manager on the Azure AD Identity Governance team.
My name is Mamta Kumar, and I'm also a program manager on the same team. Today, we'll be talking about how users from other organizations, such as partners or customers, can collaborate with us in a secure and productive manner. We will show you how to govern and manage access of these guest users that work with your employees using Entitlement Management and Azure AD Premium feature.
In this scenario, I'm an IT admin at Graphic Design Institute. Our organization works on many collaborative projects with other organizations, such as Woodgrove Bank, Contoso, and Whole Mines. As the IT admin, my topmost goal is to secure our organization and its resources, and manage access that users from other organizations have in Graphic Design Institute. As the IT admin, I'm going to show you how you can set up the external organizations to collaborate with. Let's start with the first organization, Woodgrove Bank. The main contact we work with at Woodgrove Bank is Mamta Kumar. Her email is mamtakumar@woodgrovebank.online. Using this domain information, I can add the external organization. Let's do a walkthrough on how an IT admin can set up an external organization as a connected organization. I'm going to jump into the Azure portal, and within Entitlement Management, we have a new left nav item called Connected Organizations. Within here, I can go ahead and add a new one. And let's go ahead and give it a name. So let's call it Woodgrove Bank. This represents all users from the Woodgrove Bank company. Cool. Now that we have a name and a description, we can take a look at directories and domains. Depending on the partner or other organization that you're working with, you can search by their domain, and Azure AD will look up and target that domain as your connected organization. So in the first example, we have Woodgrove Bank. My contact there is Mamta Kumar, and her email is mamtakumar@woodgrovebank.online. So let me go ahead and search by woodgrovebank.online. Here, the system will look up and find that Woodgrove Bank is an Azure AD directory, and this will add all of the users from the Woodgrove Bank directory in scope of this connected organization. Now, as I mentioned, there's multiple different organizations that I may be collaborating with. Those organizations may be in different shapes and sizes. So one of the other companies we mentioned was Contoso. My contact at Contoso is Mark. Mark's email is mark@df.tothecloud.demo.com. So let me go ahead and search real quick by that domain. Same thing. We are able to look up and find that this domain is already connected with Direct Federation. So any user associated with this Direct Federation will fall in scope of this connected org. Lastly, we work with Hannah. Hannah from Whole Mines. Her email is hannah@wholemines.org. So if I take that same domain and search, we'll find that Hannah's domain is found, and she'll be able to authenticate using one-time passcode. So it doesn't matter what size of organization the user's coming from, whether they have managed IT or don't have IT at all, you can still search by their domain, and we will be able to connect them. So let's go ahead and finish off and create Woodgrove Bank. Let's add them. So after you add the directory and domain, the next thing you get to do is add sponsors. Within connected organizations, we now have two new roles, internal sponsors and external sponsors. For internal sponsors, this represents the point of contact you have within your own organization. And external sponsors are your point of contacts from your partner organization. So let's go ahead and select an internal sponsor here. I'm going to go ahead and pick Alan. And then for external sponsors, I'm going to go ahead and pick Mamta, since she is my point of contact. I've already invited Mamta via B2B. So let me search her. So her B2B account already exists. So Mamta Kumar at woodgrovebank.online. Great. So now I can review and create. And we're going to go ahead and create this new connected organization. Awesome. Now that we've created this new connected organization, what can we do with it? We're now able to leverage these connected organizations when you create policies within access packages. So I'm going to go ahead and flip over to an access package that we've already created and create a new policy. For this policy, let's go ahead and scope it to Woodgrove Bank. All right. So traditionally, you've been able to scope access packages to users in your directory. But now you can scope them to users not in your directory. And you can choose the specific connected orgs. So in this example, I can now choose Woodgrove Bank. This allows any user from the Woodgrove Bank directory to view this access package and request it. Since these users are coming from another organization, I'm going to require approval. And since the Graphic Design Institute likely doesn't know who from Woodgrove Bank will need access, I can actually choose which sponsor I want to be the approver. So in this example, since I likely don't know the folks from Woodgrove Bank, I'm going to choose the external sponsor to be the approver. In case there is a request that comes through with no sponsor, I can go ahead and choose a fallback. So we can ensure that there's always an approver in place. So in this case, I'm going to do Alan or myself in this example. Awesome. Let's go ahead and enable this. And the rest of these settings are the same settings that we've enabled within access packages previously. So I'm going to go ahead and create this policy.
As the external sponsor at Graphic Design Institute, Joe has listed me as the approver for requests submitted by my Woodgrove Bank employees. Looking at the pending approvals, I see that there are requests that my Woodgrove Bank employees have made. I see that Bob from my company and Nadine from my company have put in requests. So let's look at Bob's request details. These look good, so I'm going to approve. Thanks for joining us to learn about collaborating with any organization, whether or not they have an identity provider. To learn more, check out our other videos.